Okay, so here's the default scene. Let's press A to select everything and press delete to delete everything. Now let's add in our infinite backdrop. So let's go to add mesh and add in a plane. Let's scale it all the way up and let's go to edit mode, go to edge selection mode and select this edge and extrude it upwards. And let's select this edge and press Ctrl B to bevel and scroll to increase the segments. Now let's go to object mode and let's shade it smooth. Okay, so let's add in our subject. So go to add mesh, and for this tutorial I'm going to add this monkey. Let's set up this monkey. Now let's add in a subdivision surface modifier and set the layers to 2 and let's apply and shade it smooth. Okay, so let's add in our camera. So go to add camera, press 0 for camera view. Now press R to rotate and double press X to rotate in the local X axis. Press G and Z to move upwards, and press G and press double Z to move it backwards. Now move it downwards. Now let's set up our camera real quick. Okay, so here's our setup. So let's go to render settings. And for the best lighting, we always use Cycles render engine. And let's turn on denoising for denoised image. So let's go to add and add in a light. And let's first cover the point light. So let's add in a point light and place it wherever you want. Now let's go to output properties and tick this render region to only render this region. Okay, so let's go to rendered view. And now as you can see, we have our point light. So what is a point light? So a point light is a small light which spreads light in every direction. Point light is mostly used for a soft lighting, which makes it the most used lighting in Blender. So let's see what we can do in our scene. So let's go to object data properties, and our scene is much darker, so let's increase the power. Let's set the power to 1000. And the units here you can see is in watts. So as you can see, we are getting much brighter light, but in this scene our lighting is pretty much unrealistic and ugly. So what we can do now? Let's try changing the distance. So as you can see, if I increase the distance, we will get much lighter shadows than before, and the direction of the shadows are getting much flattened than before. So let's move the light upward just like the sun. Okay, so the distance decides the direction and the darkness of our shadows. Now as you can see, this is very hard shadow and we want to make it soft. So when we increase the radius of our light, it will give us much softer shadows. Let's increase the radius to 5. Now as you can see, we are getting much softer and lighter shadows, but our scene is getting much darker. So let's increase the power to 1500 or 2000. Now as you can see, we are getting much natural light in our scene. Okay, so now as you can see, we are getting much lighter shadows and soft shadows in our scene, which makes it look very realistic. Let's increase the power a bit. Okay, so let's see other settings. So this is max bounces. So what max bounces does? So it will shoot a ray between the subject and the ground, and it will bounce 1024 times. So let's see cast shadows. If you turn it off, as you can see, it will not cast any shadows. I do not prefer doing it. Okay, so let's see multiple importance. So what does multiple importance do? It will reduce the noise in our shadows. So if you turn it off, as you can see, we are getting much uglier and faded shadow. But if I turn it on, as you can see, it's very uniform and soft shadow. I don't know whether you can see it or not, but I can clearly see it and you can also do it. You can follow along with this tutorial. Okay, so let's set up our light in our scene. So press Shift D to duplicate our light, and press X to move it in the X axis. Move it down a little bit. Let's decrease the power to 100 and let's decrease the radius to 0.25. Let's increase the power to 500. So as you can see, we are getting much realistic and great lighting in our scene. So let's see what we can do with our sun. Okay, so I am going to delete both of these lightings. Okay, so let's add in a sun. Okay, so now what sun does? So what the sun does is that it uniformly spreads all the lighting in all over the scene, and its location and its position never matter where it is, because if you move it here and there, it will always stay the same. But its rotation matters. If you rotate it in the Y axis, as you can see, the direction of the shadow is changing. Okay, so the sun is not much that complex in Blender. What you can do is that you can increase the angle. So what does the angle does? It's as same as the radius in point light. So if you increase the angle, let's say 15 or 100, as you can see, we are getting much softer and lighter shadows in our scene. So let's brighten up our scene. So set that to 100. Oh, 100 is so much brighter. 10, not okay, 5. Okay, so as you can see, we are getting uniform shadows in all our scene. Let's try rotating it a bit. So let's rotate in the Y axis. Okay, so now as you can see, we are getting the same lighting as we have done with the point light. But what the sun specially does, it uniformly spreads lighting in all our scene. Even when we get outside the camera, as you can see, the lighting here and the lighting here is not different. It's the same. Okay, so let's add in a spotlight. And the spotlight is very interesting one. If you have ever been into a party or a concert, you have seen such a lighting like this, just like this. So I hope you understand what is it. Anyways, let's see what it can do. So if you increase the radius, it will give much softer lighting, just like point light and the sun. And if you decrease the radius, it will give much sharper shadows. And there are some extra settings in spotlight. So let's see the spot size. So if you increase the spot size, you can see the radius of the triangle here increases as we increase the spot size, as you can see here, and it also gives softer lighting. So let's see what is blend. So let me just decrease the spot size and the radius. Okay, so what does the blend does? If you increase the blend size, it will give us a linear fall off between the brightest and the darkest part of our shadows. If you decrease it all the way down, you will get a much harder lighting. So let's increase the radius, and the blend and the radius works in the same way, but there are two different settings. I don't know why, but both of them are useful. Also, the location, the position of the spotlight matters, and if you rotate it, the direction of the shadow will change. just like this. So let's set up light with spotlight also. So as you can see, spotlight is very useful for storytelling or more cinematic type of look. So let's see what does the area light does. So let's add in an area light. Area light is exactly as same as the point light, but it has a square shape instead of a radial direction, just like point light. It can cover huge portions in squares and rectangles, which the point light doesn't do. So let's rotate it on the y-axis. So let's press R, Y and 90, and press minus for minus 90. Okay, so let's move it far away. Okay, so let's increase the power to 500 or 1000. So as you can see, it's kind of like the headlights in cars or taillights on cars. So let's increase the size. So now as you can see, the portion here is much brighter and the portion here is much darker, which is different from the spotlight, point light and the sun. So the area light is mostly used for the scenes which are far away from the subjects and covers a huge area, just like the sky behind the mountains or a castle with many lights. So in area light, the rotation of the light doesn't affect the direction of the shadows, and area light is my favorite for studio lighting. Let me show you how. So here I have a area light on the right side, and I'm going to also place it on the left side. So press Shift D to duplicate and press R, Z, 180 degree. Okay, so I'm going to decrease the power to 100. So now as you can see, this light is best for studio lighting or showroom lighting. For example, if you want to showcase your supercar or a piece at a museum. So let's see another type of lighting, which is an HDRI. Okay, so the last type of light in Blender is an HDRI. So what is an HDRI? An HDRI is an image which gives natural surrounding lights in our scene. So the best place to get HDRI is Polyhaven. Also, this video is not sponsored, so the link of the Polyhaven is in the description. So let's go to Polyhaven and browse HDRIs. And as you can see, here are many HDRIs that you can use. There is a preview of how the HDRI work. So this is for sharp lighting, this is for soft and calm lighting. So let's download one of them. So let's download this Drakenstein query. So let's download 2K image and HDR. So let's hit download and let's open it in Blender. So let's go to world settings, and here in the color, press this yellow dot and go to environment texture, and then open the HDRI you have downloaded. So as you can see, we are getting much lighting in our scene. So let's move out of our camera, and as you can see, an HDRI covers our whole scene. So let's go to camera view, and for now let's go to shading tab and go to world, and let's go to camera view and turn on rendered view. So to move or to rotate our HDRI, we have to assign it a texture coordinate node. So click our image texture and press Ctrl T if you have node wrangler add-on turned on. So let's go to rotation, and if you play with the Z rotation, you can eventually see that we are rotating our HDRI. So let me show you. So let's, as you can see, we have rotated our HDRI. So for a good demonstration, let me choose another HDRI. So for now, let's choose this J&D Gray Park. So now, as you can see, we are getting sharper shadows for our demonstration. So let's set the Z rotation to 0. And now, as you can see, we have rotated our HDRI. So let's see the settings. So for the power, you can increase its strength to whatever number. Let's decrease it. And to get softer shadows for our HDRI, you can add in a gamma node. So let's add in a gamma and plug it here and decrease the gamma to 0.4. Now, as you can see, we have softened all of the shadows. Let's increase the power to 20 or 5. Let's increase the gamma. Okay, so the lesser the gamma, the softer or the fitted the light will be. If you set it to 1, it will be at default. So let's set that to 0.6 and set the strength to 10. So now, as you can see, we have lightened our scene with an HDRI. Let's decrease the power to 5 and increase the gamma. Okay, so the type of shadow depend upon the type of HDRI you use. So this HDRI will only give you lighter and sharper shadows. So the one last bonus tip I can give to you is that you can choose the HDRI supporting your scene. For example, let's see. So if I have an interior scene, I will choose this HDRI. Or if I have a sunset scene, I will choose this HDRI. So it depends upon the scene you have, but an HDRI is an excellent way of lighting in Blender. So that's it guys, we have covered every type of lighting in Blender and I hope you have understood them very well. If you like this video, hit that like button and consider subscribing for more great content, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.